Welcome to ECE 3300 at the University of Utah. This is an introduction to electromagnetics, and we're going to begin with lecture number one, which is a review of the electric and magnetic fields, the forces associated with them, and their sources. The electric field is described by Coulomb's law. You've seen Coulomb's law before in physics. What it says is if you have two like charges, either both positive or both negative, that they are going to repel, and if you have two charges of different polarity, a positive and a negative charge, they are going to tend to attract. Let's call this charge Q1, and let's call this charge Q2. The magnitude of the force associated with either of these two charges is found by multiplying the charges, Q1 times Q2, dividing by 4 pi epsilon naught, and then the distance squared between them. This right here is R12. That's the distance from charge number 1 to charge number 2. The force is given in newtons. The charges are given in coulombs. And of course, the distance is given in meters. We all know, though, that the force is a vector quantity. This force right here is the force on charge 2 caused by charge 1, and it is going to be the opposite of the force on charge 1 caused by charge 2. So force 1, 2 is going to be the negative of force 2, 1. Let's find force 2, 1. Force 2, 1 is going to be the magnitude that we have above, Q1 divided by Q1 times Q2 divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, and then the distance between them squared. And then we need to define the direction. The direction right here is going to be given by a unit vector, r, from 1 to 2, and that's a unit vector. So r from 1 to 2. Let me draw that right here. R is going from 1 to 2. That's the unit vector that's describing the force on charge 2 caused by charge number 1. Over here, this would be the unit vector from 2 to 1. There's a constant that's important here. It's epsilon naught. It is called the permittivity, or the electrical permittivity. We can see that this is the permittivity of free space because of the naught, or the zero, that's shown here. The magnitude of the permittivity of free space is 8.854 times 10 to the minus 12 farads per meter. So this gives us a complete picture of the force that is caused by a charge. The electric field is associated with this force. Let's take a charge right here and a charge right there, Q1. And Q2, and let's say that we want to find the electric field right here where Q1 is. The way we do that is we let Q1 be 1 coulomb. Sometimes we call this taking a test charge of 1 coulomb and putting it the location that we want to find the electric field. Well, the electric field then will be a vector quantity, and it will be Q1 times Q2 over 4 pi epsilon naught r from 1 to 2 squared, and it's going to be in which direction? Right here. If we want to find the electric field here, we want the force on Q1. So E at location number 1 is going to be this. So it's going to be r from 2 to 1, and that's going to tell us the force that happens from that's caused by charge 2 at the charge 1 location. This is the electric field at that location number 1.